Hello. Today I have some topics to talk about. At first there was another shooting in Great Mills High School. Two students were shot from another student. A 17-year-old male student shot two other students at Great Mills High School in Maryland on Tuesday morning before a school resource officer engaged him and stopped the threat, authorities said. The incident began in a school hallway at 7:55 a.m., just before classes started. Authorities say Austin Wyatt Rollins, armed with a handgun, shot a female and a male student. The shooter had a prior relationship with the female student, St. Mary's County Sheriff Tim Cameron said. School resource officer Blaine Gaskill responded to the scene in less than a minute, the sheriff said. Gaskill fired a round at the shooter, and the shooter fired a round simultaneously. And now we'll leave you with the official update.
The victims of the shooting were transported by EMS, and the one male student went to MedStar St. Mary's Hospital, is in stable condition. The female student was transported to shock trauma facility, is in critical condition. And I am told that at 10:41 a.m. this morning, the shooter was confirmed deceased at Charles Regional Medical Center in La Plata. When the shooting took place, our school resource officer, who was stationed inside the school, was alerted to the event and the shots being fired. He pursued the shooter, engaged the shooter, during which that engagement he fired a round at the shooter. Simultaneously, the shooter fired a round as well. So in the hours to come, in the days to come, through detailed investigation, we will be able to determine if our school resource officer's round struck the shooter. The school resource officer is uninjured and was not struck by any firearm projectile. The SRO is with our detectives now, as are witnesses to the event. They are still at the high school in a secured area. The remainder of the students from Great Mills High School, as our protocol and process and training, we brought buses in and had them removed to the Forest Tech Center in Leonardtown for parent reunification. That is ongoing as we speak. I would like to thank my colleagues from the allied agencies that responded. It was a mass response this morning from police, fire, and rescue. Charles County Sheriff's Office, thank you, Troy Berry. Major Morris, thank you. The Maryland State Police responded, as did the NAS Police, Calvert County Sheriff's Office, the FBI, and the ATF. At 1 o'clock, I hope to give you more details about this event. I know that you have a number of questions, and I'm alerted to a number of things that are out there about the potential relationship between the shooter and any of the victims. At this time, we can't confirm any of that. That is what this investigation will do. And at 1 o'clock, I would anticipate being able to release identities of perhaps the shooter and the victims as well. And we would know by then that notification is being made. So again, I wanted to lay the groundwork for what's to come at 1 o'clock.
Can you confirm the identity of the school resource officer?
No, I can't, not at this time.
There have been threats posted on social media a month or two ago at this school. Can you say anything about if any of what happened today was related to that?
So that's part and parcel to the investigation we'll go on to determine if anything on social media was relevant to this day. I'm not aware of anything, but again, we're gonna go back and comb through that as well as anybody involved, their social media posts.
How many resource officers are for the school?
We have a school resource officer assigned to each of our high schools.
One?
Yes, yes.
Again, we're not taking questions right now at 1 o'clock. I appreciate it. Thank
you. I would like to mention that the FBI has set up a 1-800 line. It's 1-800-CALL-FBI. If you have additional information that you would like to share with us, we set that 800 line up. So please give us a call there. I'll see you all again at 1 o'clock. Thank you all very much.
Sure, sure. From what you know right now, can you just speak at all a little bit broadly about the response to this today, both the school resource officer's response and the police and EMS response in the immediate aftermath?
Yeah, so as I said, it was a mass response. You know, this is what we train for, this is what we prepare for, and this is what we pray that we never have to do. And on this day, we realize our worst nightmare, that our greatest asset, our children, were attacked in one of our places of a bastion of safety and security, one of our schools. So obviously that's what we're talking about right now across the country. And, you know, the notion of it can't happen here is no longer a notion. So despite training, you hope that you never have to do this, ever. And so now we're a very tight-knit community. And so now what I would ask our community to do would be pray for those victims and hope that we can return to some type of normalcy in our schools and in our community.
When was your last formal active shooter training exercise?
We train on that all the time, and in the schools was in the last calendar year. In fact, unfortunately, we've had incidences that were people with guns in some of the schools and bomb threats, which we treat similarly. So we talk about school safety, school response weekly. In fact, we've done a number of parent meetings, community meetings on this within the last couple months. That's all the questions I'm going to take. I'll see you at 1. Thank you.
You guys, please don't.
The second topic is Tag Movie, the official trailer released today. For 1 month every year, five highly competitive friends hit the ground running in a no-holds-barred game of tag they've been playing since the first grade, risking their necks, their jobs and their relationships to take each other down with the battle cry, "You're it." I will not talk a lot, I will leave you enjoy the trailer.
Hey guys. This is Jeremy Renner. I want to introduce the trailer to a movie called Tag. Men will play in the game right now, so... God!
Susan, you take Jerry to be your husband.
What's the difference between Episcopalian and Lutheran?
Episcopalians don't eat fish.
That's pescatarian. That's not a religion.
They're all fanatics. I don't know.
You may kiss the bride.
I love you.
Please tell me what's going on here.
Our group of friends has been playing the same game of tag for 30 years.
What?
For the entire month of May, every year, we play tag.
You got me.
You never know when someone's gonna pop up.
Congratulations, buddy. You're it.
Doing great, Anna.
Our buddy Jerry, he's the best that ever played.
And now he wants to retire.
Never been tagged. Just saying.
So who's it?
You can't touch this.
See, here we get Jerry.
You can't touch this.
Synchronize your watches.
I don't know how to do that.
I don't wear a watch.
Time is a construct.
Some couples go on cruises. Some couples go camping. Some couples go to strip clubs and have gangbangs. And this is just what we love. This is our gangbang.
Wow.
It seems like the game has really kept you guys connected.
All right. So good to see you. Come on. It's been a while since we've done this.
This game has given us a reason to be in each other's lives.
I think your dad would have really wanted you to be. Yeah.
Get up! I'm gonna keep on trying.
Eat my dick.
Balls.
Butt. Ice cream.
What?
He knows I'm lactose intolerant. He's taunting me.
Don't you know I'm gonna make him a man?
Hello again. Won't you be my neighbor? Don't worry, I'm not moving, I am happy here. Won't You Be My Neighbor? Is a new movie from Morgan Neville. It looks good. Again, won't talk a lot and we'll leave you with the trailer.
A television program for children made its unauspicious debut on station WQED in Pittsburgh. Its host, Fred Rogers.
Mr. Rogers?
Yeah.
I want to tell you something.
What would you like to tell
me? I like you.
I like you, my dear. Thank you very much for telling me that.
You take all of the elements that make good television and do the exact opposite. You have Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. Low production values, simple set, unlikely star. Yet, it worked.
Hello.
I've always felt that I didn't need to put on a funny hat or jump through the hoop to have a relationship with a child.
He was always trying to get a message across in every show.
A week on death.
What does assassination mean?
On divorce.
Some people get married and after a while they're so unhappy that they don't want to be married anymore.
He was radical. I know everyone says that, but he was radical.
They didn't want black people to come and swim in their swimming pools. My being on the program was a statement for Fred.
A neighborhood was a place where at times that you felt worried, scared, unsafe, would take care of you.
He had a singular vision of kindness and love.
Love is at the root of everything. All learning, all relationships, love or the lack of it.
Children have very deep feelings, just the way everybody does. There must be times when you do feel blue. I'm not feeling blue right now, though.
Me neither.
Won't you be my neighbor? Well, I suppose it's an invitation. It's an invitation for somebody to be close to you. The greatest thing that we can do is to help somebody know that they're loved and capable of loving.
Won't you please, please won't you be my neighbor?
The last thing is WWE wrestling. Roman Reigns is brutally ambushed by Brock Lesnar. After Roman Reigns violated his suspension and was taken into custody for trespassing, the Beast Incarnate eviscerated his WrestleMania opponent. Again, we'll leave you with the video.
Braun Strowman entered the Tag Team Battle Royal without a partner. And he won without a partner. So with that in mind, I have to come up with what I'm going to do about Braun Strowman and...
Wait a minute. That is Roman Reigns. Reigns is here live.
Roman was temporarily suspended by Mr. McMahon last week.
Where's Brock at? I was told that he's running a little bit late. You're going to have him in 3 weeks. You will have Brock Lesnar in the palm of your hands at WrestleMania 34. Do you understand me?
Well, Kurt, I do understand, but I still don't care. This is Dallas, Texas. And I've made a whole bunch of memories up in here, huh? And I'm not leaving this ring until I make one more tonight.
Anything you say,
what are you doing?
Can be used against you.
You want to read the Miranda rights right now?
You have the right to be
on your choice. You're Mirandizing Roman Reigns here, reading his rights.
You're wasting time. Everybody's if you cannot afford to hire a lawyer, one will be appointed to represent you.
Wasting the time. I'm letting him do his job, huh? He's doing his job, man.
You understand each of these rights I explained to you?
Get out of the way.
Hey, hey, hey. No.
I told you, I'll leave. But don't you touch me. You understand?
Come on.
I understand you got a job. Don't touch me. Come on, Roman.
Oh, no. Roman Reigns has had enough, and now it's come to this. Roman's completely lost it. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Oh! Brock Lesnar's here. The Beast is here, and the situation is dire for Reigns. Roman Reigns is handcuffed. Roman Reigns is handcuffed. And Lesnar... with a suplex to Reigns and now a chair. And an assault to Roman Reigns, who is defenseless. Roman Reigns can't defend himself. He's handcuffed. merciless Lesnar. And the Beast continues to assault Reigns. And in another German suplex. This is nothing short of a street mugging.
Kind of ironic, Michael, that he came in and said that somebody had to show up to represent the main event at WrestleMania.
Let's get him on the gurney, guys. Come on, guys.
No. Not again.
Reigns is strapped to the back.
Will somebody do something? This
Wait
man.
A sec.
Lesnar's the one who should be arrested, not Roman Reigns. Come on now.
It was one thing when there were just handcuffs on.
Oh, come on, what's the difference, Coach? Reigns was defenseless when this attack first started.
Well, he can't even use his arms now.
Now he's strapped to a backboard. He's motionless out there. Will somebody get down here and do something about this?
Get the U.S. Marshals back out here. Get Dallas PD. Somebody's got to stop this.
Hey, the U.S. Marshals were quick to be out here when Reigns was trespassing.
Well, that's all I have for today. Put your opinions and suggestions in the comments. Don't forget to put likes and share the video. Goodbye, my friends.